have 1 foot on the wall, and then the 1 foot on the rebounder. We're going to lift the calf up. As we're pulling back, you lift the calf up a little bit, and then you pull back so that you can feel it in your upper body and your lower body. Rebounder towards the rim as you are pushing back. Pull back and you can feel it in your upper body and your core. I have 1 foot on the wall, about mid-wall, and I'm going to sit back, and when I come forward, I am going to go up onto the ball of my foot. And then when I come back down, I'm going to stretch back so I can feel it in my upper body. And you're going to feel it. You're going to tuck your core in each time you lift up your heel on the mat. Foot up high as I can get it, and I'm just going to stretch back. And as I stretch back, I'm working my triceps, the back of my arms, and my core. Hold your core in and keep it engaged.
When everything is broken, this wall's been building in your mind, but you'll find a way to live these dreams you hold inside. You can't just live within your grasp, 'cause what's out of reach are all the things that you were meant to be. I will make
up on the wall, just a little bit outside, not too far out, and I'm going to sit back into that move. It's a rocking move, so you rock back so you feel it in your triceps, and you'll feel it in your core, and you're going to feel it in your legs.
It's going right. Don't let your heart start to bend. Don't give up the fight. You cannot live by what you see. Only believe. It's time to let it go. Step into the unknown. It takes your breath. Don't let it slip away.
one knee, I have one foot on the wall, and I have both my arms off the rebounder. And I am tucking, doing abdominal tucks along with pelvic tucks, the glute tucks. Hold your core in tight and keep your foot pressed hard against the wall to feel it in the core. Circling 20 to one side, and then I'll stop, and then I'll do 20 the other way. So we're going to be doing circles one way for 20, and then the other way for 20. Life's too precious and short to waste your time on me. The tears they feel. I'm going to put that foot on the wall, and I'm going to sit back onto the wall. I'm going to do sit backs with my foot onto the wall as I rock back and forth.
that you'd be there and try to show that you care. You left me standing here all alone. Just when I needed you and thought that you would come through, I lifted my voice, but you were gone. You should have seen today. State of suffering when I start to think of all the things that should have been. You can't hold me back, 'cause I am not giving in when I start to think.
I'm on one knee and I'm gonna have one leg high onto the wall, and I'm tucking my abdominals in and my glutes in. And as I pull up, you will notice that my knee comes up just a little bit. And you're going to work your core, and you're going to work your triceps and your upper body with this knee. Keep your core engaged.
That you have done affects me. I pray that you hear my silent cries. You should have seen today. State of suffering when I start to think of all the things that should have been. You can't hold me back, but I have got to forgive. I can't live my life in all the things that should have been. You should have been more than just lies.
Have both hands on the floor, one knee on the rebounder, and my other foot straight. It's up against the wall, the foot, and I am doing some push-ups.
Your promises behind, you should have saved me. Taking my hand because I believe.
I have my hands out a little bit further and I'm pushing back so I can get my triceps in there a little bit more. So you notice that my arms are pulling all the way back and I'm rocking back into that.
You can't hold me back, but I have got to forgive. I can't live my life in all the things that should have been.
Stretch back enough so I can feel it deep into my glutes and my tricep.
Thanks to love.
be on our sides. I'm on my elbow on one arm. And then I have my feet up against the wall, and I'm just pushing up against the wall. I'm just in a pushing motion. And once I'm done pushing onto the wall, you will notice that I will just hold that position. I'll just hold that position with one foot on the wall. I'm on my elbows, and I am going to put both feet up onto the wall, but I'm just going to hold it for 10 seconds, and then I'm going to come down onto the rebounder. So it's only 10 seconds that you're going to hold that, and then I hold 10 seconds while I'm kneeling on the rebounder, and I'll step back up again, and then I'll hold for a count of 10. Keep your core engaged. Similar move we did earlier, but this time your foot's going to be pointed outward as you rock back into that move. Keep your foot engaged into the wall and keep your core engaged too, and just push back onto the wall. Thank you. my hands on the rim. I have one foot up again on the wall. And I'm going back in a back motion as I'm doing a semi-tricep push-up. So I'm going down as far as I can as I'm holding on to the rim to work my triceps. And that will work your core too. Pulsing push-ups with one foot on the wall and hold that foot tight up against the wall and keep your core engaged. Engage your core and work your core a little bit more.